Welcome to our tutorial video for DJI Dock 3, where we will show you how to use DJI Dock 3 for the first time. You will carry out the first flight task by adding your device, virtual cockpit, planning a route, and distributing the task. Enter DJI Flight Hub 2. Click on Devices, then Dock. In the Actions list, click on Edit to assign the DJI Dock to an established project. Enter the project. Check the status of the dock. Ensure the device is idle and there are no error messages. On the project team page, click on device status window to check wind speed, temperature, satellite quality, flight altitude, and other information. Click on live to view inside and outside of the dock. Click the dock icon to quickly locate it. Click the actions button to modify parameters, including the max flight altitude and the max flight distance. It also allows for quick entry into the remote debugging mode. Click to enter the virtual cockpit mode. The left side of the screen displays the map information and locations of the dock and the aircraft. The right side displays the aircraft camera view and parameter information. You can freely adjust the display ratio of the screen. Set the information, including task altitude. Click on take off. The aircraft will ascend to the preset takeoff altitude. Pressing keys 1, 2, 3 can switch among the wide-angle camera, the zoom camera, and the infrared thermal camera. Pressing keys W, S, A, D, C, Z, Q, and E can control the forward, the backward, the ascending, and the descending movements of the aircraft. Pressing the key X can switch speed modes. Pressing keys R and F can record videos and take photos. Pressing the space bar can immediately stop the current action of the aircraft to avoid risks. Pressing the left, right, up, and down keys can control the gimbal's pan and tilt movements. Pressing the key V can enable mouse look. The aircraft gimbal will tilt following the mouse cursor. Pressing the key B can enable the intelligent subject detection, which can find vehicles and boats, and alerts can be enabled. Pressing the key G can enable smart track. Pressing the key E can start smart track. Pressing the key Q to stop smart track. Double-click the left mouse button to quickly focus on the subject. Press and hold the left mouse button to drag the gimbal direction. Right-click to select an area on the screen to zoom in. You can also use the mouse wheel to zoom in. Enable the laser rangefinder function. It will display the distance between the subject and the dock aircraft, as well as the altitude and coordinates of the subject. Select a pinpoint on the map. Right-click the mouse to set the aircraft to fly to the location. After all the operations are completed, click the close button on the top right of the screen to exit. If the aircraft has no flight route task before entering the flight control mode, after exiting, the aircraft will fly back to the dock and land on the dock. Enter the flight route library page and click on Create Route. Select the route type, the aircraft, the model and accessories. Name the flight route. Click OK. Set the reference takeoff point. Select the flight route icon. Click to quickly add waypoints. Each waypoint can be set to perform actions including taking photos and recording videos. Set the altitude mode, the flight speed, and other parameters. Save the flight route. Additionally, you can edit the flight route through the first-person view. Click on Task Plan Library and enter the Task Plan Library page. Click to create a new plan. Enter the plan name. Select the desired route from the flight route library. Select the device, the positioning accuracy mode, and the plan timer. Set the RTH altitude relative to the dock. Set the signal lost action during flight. It is recommended to set return to home. Click OK. The aircraft in the dock will automatically perform the task. Click the media files icon to enter the page. View photos, videos, and playback files of live stream recordings. Click to detect changes. Create a new task. Enter the task name. Select a route. Select the media files generated during flight. Click OK. the same type of photos taken at the same waypoint will be automatically matched. Set filter objects. When vehicles are selected, they will not be considered as a change. Adjust the minimum change region. Click to start detection. After the detection is complete, you can view marked change areas. Click to view report. The report includes information such as the detected object details and statistics of change areas. Thank you for watching.